Okay, I've got a video sequence here which has been recorded 1920 by 1080, and the sequence is a short video intro here, followed by a title, and then there's another video clip just after that. But what I'm wanting to do is make a square video out of this so that I can use it on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. What I need to do then is I need to go to the sequence settings. So if I click on sequence settings there, you can see that it's 1920 by 1080. And what I'm going to change it to is 1920 by 1920. Now, some people change it to 1080 by 1080. I prefer 1920 by 1920. As long as it's 1:1 aspect ratio, it doesn't really matter. So if I just OK that and OK that as well, what I've now got is a square video. So you can see the intro there, then it goes into the title, and then the video clip. Now, the good thing about these sorts of square videos is that you've probably seen these on Facebook as well. There are white bands at the top and bottom, and what you can do with those is you can stick in a title, you can stick in other text at the bottom as well. Now, I'm just going to delete those because there is something else that I want to do. And what I want to do is I want to change my first intro video. I actually want to make that larger to fill the square. So I'm going to double click on the video, and you can see the scale there is 100 at the moment, but what I want that to be is 177.8. That is the perfect number for filling up the screen. So what I've now got is a sequence which has my intro video filling up the square. Then I've got my title, and then I've got my normal size video. If I want to export that, then I can go to File, Export, Media. So what I've chosen is 640 by 640. If you go to the presets, then you can see there's Twitter 640 by 640. There are other settings you can choose. You can play around with these. I've changed that to 2 pass, for example. And that's it. That's how you get the square video.